All right, guys, so this video is all about modeling and balancing equations. Now, I have a balanced beam for us, or some of us can think of it as a seesaw, okay? There's two sides to every seesaw. There's the right-hand side and the left-hand side. Now, let's look at the right-hand side. On the right-hand side of the seesaw, I have 1, 2, 3 circles. On the left-hand side, I have 2 squares and a circle. Okay? What I want you to do is I want you to figure out how much each circle is worth and how much each square is worth. Okay? In order to do so, I'm going to give you a couple hints. Okay? The first hint I'm going to tell you is that the right-hand side of this seesaw is worth, or it weighs, 12. Okay, the left-hand side of this seesaw weighs 8. Okay, obviously this seesaw is not balanced, but I just want us to figure out how much each figure or how much each shape is worth. Okay, so take a moment and try to figure that out. And if you need to, go ahead and pause the video and try figuring out how much each one is worth. Okay. I'm going to start with the right-hand side, and I'm going to try to figure out how much each circle is worth, just because the right-hand side has all circles. So it might be easier to figure out how much the circles are worth using the information that I gave you. So if the right-hand side has 3 circles, and the right-hand side is equal to 12, then how much is each circle worth? Hopefully you said each circle was worth 4. Okay. 4 times 3 is 12, so that is correct. Now, if each circle is worth 4, then we can go ahead and fill in this circle on the left-hand side with the number 4. Now, let's look at the left-hand side and try to figure out how much each square is worth. Each square, there's 2 squares, and if the left-hand side equals 8, and we already know that this circle is worth 4, then that means we only have 4 more left to give, or 4 more to divide up among these 2 squares. So if I only have 4 to divide among 2 squares, how much is each square worth? Hopefully you said 2, and if you did, you are correct. Okay, so 2 plus 2 is 4, and the left-hand side is equal to 8. Okay, so we figured out, just by using clues, we figured out how much each figure was worth. Now, in the beginning, we didn't know how much each shape and square was worth. So, in the beginning, the circles and squares were kind of like variables to us. They were unknown, okay? But using, like I said, the clues, we were able to figure out how much our unknown was worth. All right, guys. So, what you're looking at right now is my equation-solving board. And every equation has 2 parts, the left-hand side and the right-hand side. In the middle of the left and the right is the equal sign. What you'll also notice on this board is a key. Now, the key says if I'm subtracting, I'm going to use the red side of the counter. But if I'm adding, I'm going to use the white side of the counter. Okay? We use counters when we're dealing with positive and negative numbers. So in this case, the red side is our negative side and the white side is our positive side. So let's look at the equation that we have on the board. The equation says m plus 3 is equal to 5. So the left-hand side is m plus 3. The right-hand side is 5. So to solve this, I'm going to model it for you first. For the variable of m, I'm going to use a cup. Since I'm adding 3, and for addition, I'm using the white side, I need to put 3 white on the left side of the equation. On the right-hand side, I have positive 5 or plus, or positive, I have positive 5, so I'm going to put 5 positive on the right-hand side of the equation. Okay, so here's our equation. Now, when we balance equations, whatever we do to the left-hand side, we have to do to the right-hand side. It's kind of like fractions. Whatever we do to the numerator, we have to do to the denominator. All right? The goal of balancing equations is to get the variable. In this case, the variable is m, and for the variable m, remember, I'm using the cup. The goal is to get that cup on one side of the equation all by itself. Okay? We want to get that cup all by itself. But you'll notice the cup is on the left hand side of the equation, and on the left side of the equation, I have these three positive. Okay? So I want to get rid of those three. I want the cup to be all by itself on the left hand side. So in order to solve this problem, or in order to balance this equation, I'm going to use the inverse operation. Now, inverse operation just means opposite operation. Now, notice, in this equation, my operation is addition. So what is the inverse operation of addition? Hopefully you said subtraction, and you are correct. The inverse operation, or the opposite operation of addition, is subtraction. So in order to solve this problem, I need to take away, or I need to subtract. So since those three are on the left-hand side of the equation, to get rid of them, I'm just simply going to take them away, or subtract them, and now they're gone. But remember, whatever you do to the left, you have to do to the right. So since I took three from the left, I need to take three from the right. Okay? Now look at the board. All we have left is the variable m, and on the right-hand side we have 2. We've balanced, or we solved our equation. M is equal to 2. Now, can we check it? Of course we can. Let's replace the variable of m with 2. Let's put our original 3 also on the left-hand side of the equation. And then we need to put the 5 back on the right. Remember, right now all we're doing is checking to make sure that we are correct and that our equation is balanced. Okay? So m, or 2, plus 3 is equal to 5. 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. We're correct. This time I'm going to model a subtraction problem. So let's look at the equation that we have on the board. On the left-hand side, I have z minus 2. And on the right-hand side, I have it equal to 8. Okay? So just like before, for my variable z, I'm going to use a cup to represent my unknown. Since I have minus 2, before, I used the white side of the counters because we're adding. But this time, since we're subtracting, I'm going to use the red side of the counters. So I need to put 2 red on the left-hand side of the equation. Now on the right, I have positive 8, so I'm going to use 8 white to represent the positive 8. Okay, so here's my equation. Z minus 2 is equal to 8. Now, we're subtracting. What is the inverse operation of subtraction? Hopefully you said addition, and if you did, that's correct. The inverse operation, or the opposite operation of subtraction, is addition. So in order to get rid of that minus 2, I need to add. Okay, so in order to balance this equation, I need to add. Remember, the goal of balancing an equation is to get the variable, or the cup, on one side of the equation all by itself. So again, in order to solve this problem, I'm going to add. So I'm going to add the opposite of what's on the board on the left-hand side. Since I have 2 red, I'm going to add the opposite of red, which would be white. And remember, whatever you do to the left side of the board, you have to do to the right side of the board. So since I added 2 white on the left, I'm going to add 2 white on the right. Okay? Now notice, hopefully this brings you back to when we were adding and subtracting integers. What happens when you have a positive and a negative? What happens to a pair of them? What are they called? I'm hoping you said zero pairs, and if you remember, 1 negative plus 1 positive They cancel each other out, okay? So since these two are 1-0 pair, I'm going to take them away. They cancel each other out. And these two also form a 0 pair, so they cancel each other out. So I'm going to take them away. So on the left side, left side of the board, we're now left with the variable z, or the cup. And z is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10. Okay? So z is equal to 10. Let's check it. If we're saying z is equal to 10, on the left side of the board, I'm going to put these 10. Okay, so here's 10, 10 counters, minus 2, so I'm going to put the 2 back on there, the 2 red, is equal to 8. Now you put the 8 back on there. Okay, so z, 10, minus 2, is equal to 8. Okay, but what happens with these two? What happens to that? What can we do with that? We can form 0 pairs. So I'm going to form a 0 pair with these two. And I'm going to form a 0 pair with these two. And they're gone now. So what I'm left with is 8 on the right side of the board. And 8 on the left hand side. Okay? And just like that, we have balanced our equation. Okay, so what I want you to do right now is to go back to your equation vocabulary page in your composition notebooks. We need to add two more definitions. The first one is inverse operations. Inverse. I-N-V-E-R-S-E. And inverse operations means to me opposite operations. The examples we used today was that addition is opposite of subtraction, and subtraction is opposite of addition. Again, if you need to pause the video to write these down, you can. The last vocabulary word we're going to add is solution. Solution. And to me, solution means the answer for the unknown that would balance or make the equation true. Remember, the whole goal for equations is to balance them and make sure that the left side of the equation is equal to the right side of the equation. We did a lot of modeling in today's video. Remember, on the test, a lot of the questions are going to be models. You won't necessarily have to solve to figure out the value of the variable, but you do have to know what the first step would be in order to solve the equation. Again, remember, in order to solve equations, we need to use inverse operations. And hopefully you grasp the concept of that vocabulary word. Inverse operations, again, mean opposite operations. Addition is opposite of subtraction, and subtraction is opposite of addition. Later on, we'll be moving into multiplication and division, and we'll be using the inverse operations again there to solve those equations. Okay? So if you have any questions, again, feel free to ask me in class or email me at themissmorton@gmail.com. Remember that the 10 in Morton is actually the number 10. Okay? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in class.